Yeah, well, thanks, Mike. I'm here with Daren M. Otten, Assistant Professor and Coordinator of the Sustainable Manufacturing Program at California State University at Chico, and also Louk Hendricks, Chairman of the SME Student Chapter, S-139, and also a Sustainable Manufacturing Student at CSU Chico. Before we get to Luke's project, tell us a little bit what happened with your team down in Southern California.
Well, we're really excited, first of all, to be here today, but also to talk about our projects and our student success. We've seen a renaissance of manufacturing here in the United States continuing to grow, and our program's very reflective of that. We're starting to see lots of student growth. We're starting to see student growth from areas we traditionally haven't seen, which is female participation in this particular space. And, you know, our program combines engineering, technology, hands-on machining, casting, plastics, all these kind of things that go into the manufacturing sector, but also plugs it in with business. You know, things as dry as accounting, but you need to know how to do those sort of things ultimately in these spaces. And this project really is a culmination of all those student skills across the boards that is geared towards this Bachelor's of Science in Sustainable Manufacturing. Also should be noted that Louk and his team, this is not a class credit. This is not like they're earning any class units for this. This is all a student club, Society of Manufacturing Engineers student club, and it's all on their own dedicated time.
Okay, and so what happened, Louk, is your team, I think, a dozen of you or so went down to Southern California for the AeroDef conference, right?
Yes.
And what happened when you were down there?
Well, what happens is we went down to the competition, we brought our cylinder head, all the associated documentation that we developed with the project. And what happens is we present in front of a panel of judges among other schools who are attending. There is a college division and then a two-year university division. And the judges go through, you have 10 minutes to present your project, and then they go and they present you your award.
And you, what award did you win?
We won the Best in Show Award at the AeroDef competition. And what that is recognition of is basically recognizing that our project related and tied in to the aerospace manufacturing and defense show that they had there, and that it was also deemed pretty much the best project that was there.
Okay, so tell us about the project. It was a cylinder head, right? Maybe we can get a quick shot of this, Daniel. There we go. So this is a cylinder head. Tell us about the cylinder head. What's the purpose of it?
So the purpose of the cylinder head is to allow you to use lower octane fuel in the cylinder head as opposed to low-leaded, high-octane fuel.
And this is for aircraft engines, right?
This is for four-cylinder aircraft engines. These are typically going to go as a replacement to a Lycoming cylinder head that you're going to see on experimental aircraft. And we did all the design work for the manufacturing system on campus in our club. So what you see here is the finished product. But we were more involved in the manufacturing and the production system and all of the associated work with that.
So basically a person from outside the university came to you, said, I got this idea for for an engine that's going to run on unleaded fuel, lower octane. Mm-hmm. Can you guys somehow figure out a way to make this? Was that the idea?
Absolutely. That's exactly what happened.
And were you able to do this completely within the university facilities?
Yes. We did all of the design work for the casting and the tooling. And we did all that on campus. So we cast the part. We did the heat treatment on the aluminum, which is cast 356. And then we sent it out for the X-ray inspection. That was the only capability that we didn't have on campus. And then when it returned to us, we did all the machining on the cylinder heads utilizing our Haas CNC equipment. And then we did quality inspection using our MicroView CMM.
Okay. So what makes this part of a sustainable engineering program? Why would this qualify for because it's a lower works with lower octane gas and more fuel efficient, that sort of thing, or just better for the environment? Is that why it fits in with the sustainability?
Yeah, really, you just covered all the points, those working together. And then the other one too is that in California, the regulations for gasoline and emissions for air quality, the person who designed the cylinder head, he sees in the future those restrictions becoming greater and an increase in the requirements there.
So he's kind of getting ahead
exactly.
of the game. And I should point out, this is not for licensed aircraft, right? This is for experimental
yes.
aircraft, right? So the mm-hmm. whole, a lot of the FAA stuff doesn't really apply as it would if this was for a commercial aircraft.
Yeah, at this stage, that's just because of what's feasible right now. If, okay. you know, his ideal situation is bringing this forward and putting it through FAA certification.
And this is the 14th time? A team from your program has won down at the
Chico State and the predecessors to the Sustainable Manufacturing Program have always had a very, very good track record down at AeroDef and the predecessor competition at West Tech. And this four-year division that Luke's been talking about, I believe it is the 14th time that they've taken the top honors at that particular event.
Wow, that's terrific. So now you said one thing that's interesting is that your program has seen an increase in the number of female students, right?
It has.
In an engineering program.
Yeah,
so.
and we've seen an increase across the board in students generally who are interested in manufacturing, and then there's a lot of reasons that I think we can attribute that. Part of the challenge, of course, has been, I think, and the big takeaway, which is exciting for the future of manufacturing, especially in the United States, is that we have students today who are interested in tangible results of their daily work.
Okay. And Luke, you're graduating this year?
Yes.
Right? And are you going to be working within the same field?
I'll be taking a position that's more directly related to CNC manufacturing,
okay.
And also some production management.
And what are you taking away from this program and yourself personally? What does it mean to you?
It means a lot. I feel coming out of this program, based on the classwork and the academic strengths, and also the things that I've learned through my extracurricular activities, which is what we're talking about today, I feel very well prepared going out into the workforce, and it's something that I am very much looking forward to.
All right, awesome. So. Well, Daren, thank you for joining us. And Luke, congratulations and your team on a fantastic project and winning it down at AeroDef. That's pretty cool.
Thanks.
All right, Mike, back to you.